Happy Friday, good brothers and good sisters. You are at the altar of KHL the second, shaving and BSing. You are at the home of the King of Weepers, the worst lather and wet shaving, aka the channel should be called Tin Can't Lather. You are just blessed to be in the graces of a shaving god. Nah, I'm just having fun based on something that broke out in one of the comment sections of a previous video. I'm just BSing. I'm you know me. I am horrible. Thank you, Kendi, for the yawn. Good morning. Dog is here. All right, before we talk about product, I want to thank Uncle John Conley for a great video on Don't Be a Jerk. I watched it this morning at the gym, sir. Very cool. My mate Chris Madden at Another Cut Above in Western Australia. I told him yesterday, I am so jealous. He's got two wolf whiskers and he's 30-something on the list, so his time is coming soon for his own custom. And I'm just gobsmacked, jealous. I hate you! No, I'm just kidding. Love you, brother. All right, so let's get into the products today. So we're going to go with Merkur Progress, which I have warming up. Setting 3 to begin with, and we'll probably dial it down, knowing my skin. Going to go back to a second shave on the 7 o'clock SharpEdge from Gillette, or the yellow. Big Bruce Brush, which I'm going to dip in the warm water in the bowl here. Fine American Blend for the aftershave. Soap Commander Honor for the balm. And we're going to be featuring an artisan that's making a lot of noise right now. Every time products become available, they sell out. This is Viking Shave Soap. This is Old Norse, which is their barbershop scent. This is their tallow formulation. They have some in tallow, some fragrances in tallow, some in vegan or vegetal, depending on where you live. Viking Soap Company, handmade in Ames, Iowa, USA. Basic main ingredients, tallow, aloe, lanolin, mango, shea, and oats. Main ingredients are tallow, stearic acid, water, potassium hydroxide, coconut oil, aloe vera juice, glycerin, castor oil, sweet almond oil, sodium hydroxide, sodium lactate, mango butter, apricot kernel oil, shea butter, fragrance, hydrolyzed oats, and lanolin. Now, if you're not familiar why hydrolyzed oats is a thing, Aveeno uses it. Aveeno products or lotions, a few other things, because it helps retain moisture in the skin. So this is why things with hydrolyzed oats are very moisturizing in general. They also help somewhat with skin reactions in certain ways, because they have a powder you can put in your bath if you're having skin irritation issues. So Puck it's pretty full. It's how many ounces is it? 5.5 ounces. I believe it's like, was it 10 something? Before shipping, which was $4 shipping. Fairly firm puck. You get a lot of soap. You've seen Chris at Eyelather, CDB, the former traditional shaving evangelist, use it. He's loved it. Talked to my good brother here in town, John Perry. His firsthand, he says he absolutely loves this. It sells out every time something comes up on the website. I finally was able to get some. Man, my sink is acting up again, so we're just going to rinse as we go. So I'm going to wet the face with cold water. I'm out of the shower, so you know that drill. The shaving god thing, that was just, again, for those who aren't listening or paying attention, have learning disabilities, reading problems, listening problems, etc., that was nothing I initiated. That was in a comment thread in a previous video. I do not claim to be a shaving god. I barely claim to be a decent wet shaver. And I've been accused of that many times. So there you have it. So let's get a load on here with our big Bruce and see what's going on. I was watching a few different shaving videos today. I was watching Another Cut Above with Chris and Mersal Blue Shave today. John Connolly, Don't Be a Jerk. CDB, Initial Impressions of the, or Chris at Eyelather, Initial Impressions of the One Razor. And I was just in the middle of watching his shave with another Timeless and Oleo Soap Works out of Chicago, Melonade. another new artisan, Vita, and I forget your last name offhand. I apologize if you do see this video. I know you're in our forums. It looks like you're doing some good things. I saw Peter Tarkalis' video as well a couple days ago. Okay, so the scent profile. If you have Mike's Natural Soap Barbershop or you have Soap Commander Honor, that's what you're getting. All right, we're definitely gonna need some water. So it's a very clean, it's one of those things, when I think barbershop, this is what I get. I either think that or CAD more than anything else. Of course, I do think Pinot Clubman, but that would be for an aftershave. A little more water. The couple things I've seen on this soap is it can take water. So I'm gonna, in my adventures in this and trying to get better in all facets. Oh, I forgot one other title. The most hated man in wedge shaving. Except for maybe Douglas North. But at least we're in the same corner. While I am a non-factor, not even a blip on the radar. And you know, he is, you know, if there's a Mount Rushmore of modern wet shaving people, Doug's probably on it for better or worse in many people's opinions. I say for the better, obviously. But I'm not even a speck of dust on the, lowest part of the heel of the shoe of wet shaving, so to speak. So don't misconstrue anything I say as assigning it any importance, except I'm just having fun and BSing, believe me. So if I see any of you go, oh my God, he called himself a shaving god, this shows you're not paying attention. All right, let's get to, again, setting 3. There you go. And we'll dial it down a lot, likely. This is 2 days growth. So I was talking with a Suffolk shaver yesterday, a little bit off topic. He saw Logan. He and I are very much Marvel movie enthusiasts. And he highly recommends Logan. I have yet to see it. I mean, if you can't figure out what probably happens at the end, spoilers, you know. Apparently, it is not for you to take your kids. It is rated R. And it is violent. Apparently, it's violent like Deadpool. Doesn't quite have the comedy. So. But it's going to deliver for what a lot of people wanted in the, in a Wolverine movie, finally, apparently. Wipe off after the little semi rinse, wet the face again, and get into past 2 lathering up. New shirt I just got in, Rain Delay Gods from Cork Baseball, Game 7, 9th inning, 10:58 p.m. If you know what that means, you know why this shirt's important. I also got one from Grunt Style coming in. It's blue with a red dot with a goat in the middle. I think the goat with excise, so it's dead. And it says, "Time to gloat, November 2nd, 2016. Gloat instead of goat. For one, so it's Cubs, long-suffering Cubs fans. And I haven't suffered as long as others. I've been 30 years, but 30-plus years. I gotta do something with my sink. Gotta realign the clean and realign the drain area. All right, let's dial it down to 2. See if we can go against the grain second pass. Very nice. Oh, I gotta thank Suffolk Shaver for a tip on his last shaving video. And I never gave this thought. I mean, you know me, I stretch the skin very oddly. I open my mouth, especially when I'm doing the apples of my cheeks and lower right here. But if you overstretch your skin, you start pulling the hair back the other direction. And so, as opposed to firming it up so you can hit it, you're actually going, you're pulling with it, so you're not getting as much hair off. So, watch your... Watch how tight you pull. I mean, stretch your skin, but watch how tight you pull it. Don't pull it overly tight, I guess, is the best way to say it. And I'm working on billowing my cheeks out, blowing my cheeks out versus opening my mouth and stretching to cut down on the amount of tonsil porn you all get, you know. I'm sure it might give a few of you an odd tingle down in your plumbing, but you know, it's still, you know. That's okay. It's 2017. Teach their own, man. I don't care. I don't care how you swing. It's not my business. Just be happy and don't hurt anybody. Weeper to in my normal expected areas. That's partly the skin, partly not the best lather from me, and maybe a touch too much pressure, all combination thereof. So that's okay. they close quickly because they're not major, major problems. All right. Look at that. That's killer lather. I had to pull it out, but this soap is soft. This soap performs very nicely. It's a deal. No wonder it sells out so quickly when somebody says, hey, on Facebook, and we all scramble. The scents I hear are good. I've heard anyone say a bad word about Viking soaps yet. So I'm happy to have gotten a puck and given it a run, because I mean, this little bit even peaks. Just rinse my hands off real quick. Alright, we're gonna go across the grain, setting two. Wow, nice. Good residual slickness, very good. All right, let's do the neck. Oh, one more person I gotta thank. Chris, another cut above with Chris, set me up for a little Scottish slang, which I included in Irish themed shaving products. So I'm all over the Ireland and the United Kingdom. I got a couple of nice little Facebook voice messages from Kevy Shaves. If you watch Kevy Shaves, you know, he's a great gentleman, very entertaining, great sense of humor, and he's an actor, and he does voice work, and he's an actor, and been a great good brother to the wet shaving community. I enjoy his videos very much. And he popped into my messages before he was going to bed, because he's like 6 hours ahead of the central time zone. But he left a couple nice messages, very funny. So thank you, Kevy. I appreciate it. And if you don't subscribe to Kevy Shaves, please do. Great gentleman. Suffolk Shaver, another cut above. RazoRock Parfum, which used to be Black Country Shaver, which was Top Fragrances and something before that. Here's what's left in the brush. Peaky, cushiony. Good stuff. I cannot say anything bad about this one. This was a good shave.
different weepers in my normal areas, but otherwise.
It's a damn fine shave, so performed well. For the price per ounce, you definitely can't, you can't beat it. I mean, it's right up there in the Sterling Soap Commander price per ounce zone. And I think as the word gets out even more, Viking's gonna be a major player in the soap community. And to be honest, I may not even have done it justice. I know it performed well for me. I probably could have loaded better, but for what I did, I am very pleased with it. I'm gonna let it dry here. All right, we're gonna go, we're 20 plus minutes. Where's my, all right, you know what? Gonna rinse, we're just gonna go to the aftershave and balm. All right, we'll dry off. Oh, also the Andy Kaufman of wet shaving. I got all these titles. Some, yes, I put on myself, so let's not take that too seriously. Some, I've been kind of dubbed, for better or worse. Hey, pretty good shave, not too bad a burn at all. From the alum or the aftershave. All right. And we're gonna lock in the moisture with a little Soap Commander Honor Balm, which is our barbershop, and it's mentholated. I put too much on in my hand. So I'll spare you the Tiege Hanley, but that's coming. Just know I use it every day. All right, so be good, good brothers and good sisters. Thank you for worshiping at the altar of the shaving god. Kidding. God damn it, kidding. Be good. Have a great day. It's Friday, so we're getting into our weekend. Enjoy your weekend. Be safe. As Chris says, don't drink and drive. And just, I'm trying to be a better guy. So maybe come along that journey with me. Weight loss and stop being so snarky. All right. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye, kids.